Good morning, you all, and สวัสดีครับ. Okay, the good news for you guys today is my topic is about getting rich, right? So I think we all here want to get rich together, right? Because we get a job, and sometimes we don't get expected salary. So my topic is about to increase your income, but maybe it could decrease as well. So the method that I suggest you to increase your income today is to investing. And the access that I would like to suggest now is the stock. So I have a question for you on that. Is there anyone here trade in stock market? Please raise your hand. Oh, that's quite a lot, right? And for those who don't, it's okay. It's really okay because I know how risky to trade in stock market. And that's why I come in with this topic to reduce the trading, to reduce the risk in trading in stock market and increase your income, if it's possible. Okay, before we start, let me introduce myself first. My name is Prem Chotipanit. Right, I'm graduated from Electrical Engineering from Kaseasat University, and in the master degree, I graduated from the University of the Sheffield. And right now, I work as the financial data analyst at Thairat Group, the biggest news and media company in Thailand. And you can find more detail on my LinkedIn. LinkedIn here. And also, I would like to present my character profile, which is a bad frame. I got the competition expert and notebook master. I'm really proud to present it. Okay, let's get back to our topic. My topic today will cover three main subtopics, which include how to load the data from the data sources, which include Yahoo Finance and the one of the most popular chart provider, the TradingView. And after we got the data frame on data sets for making the algorithm, we're going to implement the strategy for trading, which we call the backtesting. And after we got the best strategy, I will introduce the idea to do the forward testing, which include my real case, my real result of forward testing on my portfolio. This is the relation of three subtopics, right? It's like a basic data engineering process, which includes loading the data from two data sources here. And after we got the data loaded, we need to implement the algorithm and emitting the signal to any API if you want. Let's start from loading the data. I have two data sources that quite popular for the traders to analyze the financial analytics. First, let's start from the easy one. We call the Yahoo Finance. And Yahoo Finance have the data stored in the database. The data stored in the database is the price, the data, and to serve to the virtualization, it use the REST API. And because this is a REST API, it's very easy to scrape it and to the Python instead. And let me show you a little bit. If you hit the inspection mode in the Yahoo Finance, you will get a lot of API running back in the background. And this is the API that facing the price data from the database to virtualization. This technique called the API scraping, but actually there are a Python module that can work on this one. But for me, I prefer scraping by myself because I don't have the proper reason. I just love to do it by myself. But you can use the module called Yahoo Finance as well. And another data source is TradingView. This one is kind of hard to scrape, but if you want to trade in the real time, is going to be very useful because the data running here is quite fast and very efficient. And but this, because this one is not running on the HTTP protocol, it's running on the WebSocket protocol, it's quite a little bit complicated. And the same here, if you click in the inspect mode and click on the WebSocket tab, you will see a WebSocket channel running in the background, and you will see the message running here fetching the price from the view database. And for those who are taking the photo, I have the coding for you. If you cannot catch up the thing that I just post up, this I just talked earlier. First, if you want to, if you want to scrape the data from Yahoo Finance, you can use this model instead. But if you want to get the data from TradingView, I provide this TradingView scraper on my GitHub repository. And I will share you after finish this session. Okay, but assume that we have the data frame ready for our Python code. It's going to be look like this one. This one, we call this one OSLCV, standing for open what? Open, high, low, close, and volume. Sorry, I forgot. Which is includes the price data. And how to interpret this? For example, if we start in the morning, the market starts, right? The market is opening. The first price is coming is the open price. The highest price in those days is we call the high price, and lowest price we call the low price. And final price before the market close, we call this one close price. And the amount order in those days we call the volume. And these five columns will be combined into this virtualization, which is we call this one the Kanten chart. The most popular virtualization for traders. And after we got the data ready for analytics, we going to do some evaluate. Then we're going to find the best algorithm to trade, to run the trading, right? And imagine that you're looking the algorithm on the internet. We will find a million of algorithm, right? And the question is, how can we know that which one is better? Which one is the best algorithm that we going to choose? I coming with the method called the back testing. The back testing is to look at the historical data and try to run the mock-up trading on those historical data and evaluate the performance of the trade of the strategy. The question is, how can we run the back testing? The most popular two most popular methods that we can run the back testing. First, we use the PyScript. The PyScript is the language you provided by TradingView. And it's already available on the TradingView. The advantage of the PyScript is because it's used on the TradingView, the data, we don't need to do the feature engineering or data engineering to fetch the data into the program. And it's, for me, it's quite easy to use for starter. But the main disadvantage is it's not a general language like Python, which means you cannot install a new module in this language, and also it's not open sources, and also like it's quite hard to import external data. For example, if you have some language model that interpret the news, that interpret the sentimental analytics, it cannot be imported into this language. It's so hard to do this. So compare with the Python is the general language. So you can import module, right? You can apply your strategy on some fancy techniques that you want, you expect it to make a trading. Yes. And that actually there are a lot of module that can run backtesting, but I prefer this one. This one is called the backtesting.py, which is a straightforward name to do the backtesting. I found it's quite a moderate learning curve, not so hard and not too easy, but still able to customization. And this module also provide, financial stat and the good virtualization. The virtualization here is provided by the Bokeh. Bokeh is an interactive virtualization and lightweight. It's quite fast. And if you want to make a machine learning model in your strategy, this one is quite preferable. This is the example snippet of the backtesting.py. You will see like we are initial this strategy, which are the simple moving average. If those two simple moving average have been crossing up, we send the signal buy signal. On the other hand, if it's crossing down, we send the sell signal. And we can include commission rate in our strategy as well for make it more realistic. And the result has been returned as the financial stat, which are including the equity, final equity return in percentage, and also the more advanced stat like a Sharpe ratio, which basically should be more than one, but this one is just simple strategy. And Sortino ratio, if you have some knowledge about financial, this can be very useful. But if you don't, the return is good enough to interpret your algorithm. Also, the win rate as well, red test as well. And the another thing that the module can provide is the base virtualization. This one is quite a little bit zoomed out, but I will show you how can we interactive with this virtualization. And you will see like the green one, the mark of the green is the show that the trading has been start, the order buy signal has been activated, and to this one mean we sell the stock and we got the profit because it's going to be green. And for the red marking is we imagine that we need to cut loss. We buy stock it at a high price and we sell it at a low price. Okay. I'm going to show you the real code. Let's see the quick start of. In this course, I use the Google Colab, which is the most popular kernel for data scientists. And we start with install the module like when we working with the data scientist project. And imagine that we already loaded Bitcoin data, and we got this data frame. We got the open, high, low, close, and volume. And also, this one is trading on the date time frame, which is quite of the more convenient for trading. I set up the function for calculate the indicator. We call this one the exponential moving average. And I set up the strategy here. I said that if the long moving average is crossed up with the short moving average, I'm going to send the buy signal. For on the other hand, if the long moving average crossed down with short moving average, I will exit those position, which means we sell those stock. And the result is showing this. Sure, we got the result which is the financial stat that we can interpret. You will see like the Sharpe ratio is quite higher than the another algorithm, and the return here is quite of the extraordinary because it's Bitcoin, and we get the win rate 60%. And let's see the visualization. BT plot here, and if we zoom in the visualization, we will see the cadence chart, right? This. It will look like the normal cadence chart in TradingView on Yahoo Finance, and because it's interactive, we can be easily interpret with these results. And you see, like the orange line is the short moving average, and the blue line is the long moving average. Also in this model, but if you look up a little bit on this one, you will see like I set up the end of the long moving average, it sell 107, and the short moving average at 20. You might wonder that how can I coming up with this number, right? Because we have the process of the optimization of the algorithm right here, down here. Oops, sorry. The optimization is to try and the range of the parameters. For example, I testing with short moving average between 5 to 30, and with the step of 5 day, and long moving average, I test with the 19 to 120 with step of 10. And I check which parameter can make the highest equity. And after that, I capture those parameters to be my best algorithm for trading. Also, you can visualize those optimization with this heat map as well. You will see like a short moving average of 10 and 90 moving average of long 90 of long moving average is going to be make the best performance. And this is the how can we make trading system with the classical technical analytics. And after this, I will show you how to make the trading system with machine learning. Okay, I'm going to move it. This one is the how to. Okay. First, what we want from the machine learning? For me, I want the machine learning to guide me what I should do daily. Should I buy the thing? Should I buy the stock? Or should I just stay still, do nothing? Or should I need to sell the stock? You will see on the function getting Y is provided here. For example, if we look back to the historical data, look back to the past, and we look ahead in the next 48 days, and we check if the price in the next 48 days is higher than 0.4%, we label as the one. But if the price is lower than minus 0.4, I label as the minus one. For otherwise, I label as zero. And this we will need to use for, how say, supervised learning. And for the X, I do the feature engineering by calculating the indicator. What indicator that I use is it's including simple moving average by 10 to 100 and delta simple moving average and Bollinger band, sorry, which is the signal that many traders use to find out when to buy the stock. Actually, it's supposed to be stock sentimental as well, but you know, like it's not available for now. So I just, if I include it, my code will crash. So I just comment it. And I do the same process. In the initialization, I use the simple decision tree classifier and just fit the data X and Y. And after that, I use as the one of the, I use this model as the one of the indicator. If the indicator show predict as the one, I will got the I will send the buy signal. Otherwise, I will just doing the sell signal or just stay still. Let's see the results of this. You see something? And look. Did you see something wrong in this? The return with trading for about 10 years is going to be 300,000%, which means yearly we will got 1,000%. That's good, right? We're going to get rich. So shall we use this algorithm? Shall we? Yes, use it. You can use it if you want to get bankrupt. The another important thing that I didn't mention in for data science, you know, what is that? Correct. It's very correct. Who said that? Thank you. We have in the data science, we have something called the overfitting, which means that we try to fit the machine learning with some parts of the data too much, and the prediction performance seem to be good for the training data, but it's not guaranteed that it's going to be better for testing data as well. And to protect that, data scientists suggest that we should use the method called, the method called cross-validation, but it's not like doing the cross-validation for any other tabular data, because the stock data is the time series data. We need to split by date. For example, if my setup point is 2020, I mean the year, and which means like the training set data is the pricing before the year 2020, and the rest will be for testing data and evaluation. Oh, okay, I put this right. And this is my. I think this is some snippet of my code. I'm moving window from 2018 and 2023. At the start, I set up that the data before the 2018 going to be my training data set, and I use my machine learning to fit the data before that. And the data after 2018, the data after 2018 will be my testing data and evaluation. And let's move, and we will capture which one have the best win rate. And this is the overall of my algorithm that I use for real trading. I also use the external data, which is the market index. For the foreigners, for Thai first, I use this one is the set index. But for the foreigners, you can use S&P index as well. For the American stock data, or for Japanese, you can use Nikkei index. And after I got the best model, I've used it for fired signal to the API. But API for bot trading in Thailand is quite hard to obtain. So I use the Slack instead to send the notification. So which means every morning I will get the signal for my model that should I buy the stock or not. Okay, let's see my forward testing results. This is my forward testing results. Copy. Why are you taking photo? And this is my forward testing result for my real portfolio, my real money as well. And it looks messy, but it's just raw data, right? And this one is the aggregation version of my stock, the trading. Finally, in this year, I can manage about 70% in return. You might find out that it's not so attractive, but I need to mention that the Thai stock this year is kind of the disaster. And also Bloomberg that suggests that Thailand is facing the economic crisis because the increasing of the technical debt, increasing of the public debt, and even worse because our government policy seem not to have some policy to handle it. And that's it. I think it's a good chance to test the robustness of my algorithm. Okay, let's get back to my slide. Okay, my presentation is going to end, but let's cover what I'm talking in this topic. And I also cover about how to load the data, how to implement the algorithm, and include technical trading and machine learning. And finally, I show how to the forward testing result. And we have the 30 minutes for presentation. Sometimes it's quite enough, right? So if you have any more questions, you can ask me after this session. Thank you.